So I'm going to be teaching you how you can live stream. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and share my screen. Again, we're on OBS. We're on a Zoom meeting. So I'm going to go over here to the over here. Now, I think your OBS should be open. So how it works is you should open it up. Now, here's the thing. Now, OBS sometimes breaks. And if you open it up by just double clicking, like that, sometimes your video, as you can see, your display capture is broken. So how you should do it is you should right click OBS, go to run with graphics processor, and then go to integrated graphics. Then that way your as you can see, my screen will show up. There you go. As you can see, my stream is ending. How do I do like that? How do I do 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 that? And how do I do, just basically that. Now I'm gonna be showing you all the tips that you need to know. So first of all, how you can live stream. Now I think I'll go over most of everything, like the sub count and everything. Now I also got this, the merch alerts. Whoever buys the merch, then they will be able to see this. But anyways, I'm gonna go ahead and get started with the first thing you need to know. So I'm gonna go live here, but I'm gonna make the live stream private because we don't need to know about that. So let's just set up a random little note here, and I'm gonna set it to public. So private, and I'm just gonna do that. No, I'm not gonna search that because that's gonna show up that. I'm gonna go there and let's just set up a random place, and let's just set up 8:25 since that's the nearest time right there. And we're just gonna create the stream. Now, obviously it says that you're going to need to connect with your streaming software in order for it to work. So how that works is you're going to need to go down here, the stream key. Now the stream key is your password. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna copy that and I'm gonna go over here to settings. Now I'm not gonna go over the output and that rest because that's private information. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna paste in that. No one should know that, or otherwise if they have it, then it's they're gonna have to stream on your side. Now, I don't want to go over everything. I'm pretty sure this is private information. Yeah, this is private information also a little bit. And the hotkeys, I just want you to know that the hotkeys are basically like this. So for example, if I say that the three key is the start streaming and the number three button is end streaming, how it works is if I go over to this, wait, save changes. If I click three, then the streaming will start. Now, then once you start streaming, I'm just gonna go over to the stream this starting. And then what's gonna happen is once it has excellent connection, it's gonna start that, it's gonna let you go live. And boom, that's how you do it. You go live. You can also do like the regular sub alerts counts. Now you can't see it because they're like that. And you can even end it off like that. And that's how you start streaming. And boom, when we click three, we can stop streaming. Now, here's the thing. Once you click stop streaming here, it doesn't mean that YouTube will stop streaming. It will start to load and wait a little bit. This is the real end streaming. And as you can see, it was zero playbacks, blah, 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 blah. And there we go, guys. And that's how you stream on OBS. Now, I'm going to go over how you do a sub count. Now, you got to go over to Social Blade right here. Socialblade.com, and you're gonna search up your YouTube channel. So you want, then what you want to do is you want to go over to live subscriber count, and then what you want to do is copy this link right here, and then what you want to do is you want to go over to your streaming section right here, and then what you want to do is you want to add something. You want to go to a browser. And what you want to do is you want to search up sub count. Now, I already have that. And then what you want to do is you want to change this, copy and paste this link right here. And then you're going to change this to 1,000. And the reason why is you'll see in a second. So as you can see, it's right in the middle. Now, I don't want to see the ads, right? So what you want to do is you want to right click that. You want to go to filters and you want to go ahead and add in a crop and a pad. Now, here's the part where it gets a little tricky. It's kind of a lucky guess. You have to guess which one is the correct one. So like, for example, 500 is too much, 250. Maybe that's not good enough. Let's try 400. maybe 425. Yeah, that's a good one. And then what we want to do is we want to change that to the top. Maybe like a 500. No, that's too much. 450. 440 maybe. 444. That's a good enough number. And then we're gonna go to the right, probably this around the same thing, not too much, maybe like 400. That's a good one. And then we're gonna do maybe like 100 is good enough. No, 100. There we go. And good enough. And you can even like make it bigger, and that's how it is. Now I have my accurate one, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna delete this one right here. I'm gonna remove it, and boom. That's how you do it. Now, you want to do this is how I do the sub goals. Now, I want to do this unedited, so here's what's going to happen. I'm going to go ahead and pause the recording so everything freezes because my docs have a lot of personal information. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to close that. And then, what I'm going to do is you're going to go to docs.google.com. And how it works is you make a new file. You want to select what you want to do and do that. Now, here's the tricky part. You want to click this. You want to click this, right? You want to click this right here. And I'm going to pause it because it does have personal information. Let me see if there is. Yeah, there is personal information. There's my email right there. You want to click that and you want to click change it to anyone on the internet with this link can view. And then change that and you copy the link. Because that's personal information. So you click this and you want to go to anyone who has the link. And then basically, what it does is if you have required people, OBS is going to use a logged out account to access that. So then, what you want to do is you want to go over to this. You want to go to browser and then do the same thing. Member goal, but I already have the same thing. You want to do this. Go ahead and copy that. Whoopsie, that's the wrong link. I did not have that cancel. And that's the same thing. And you do the same thing. Now, I mentioned that I do not use sub accounts, like whoever subscribes. I don't do that. I just use subscriber accounts. And you can even use text. So right here, you can go ahead and do text and you can do subscribe. And you can even change the font, maybe like that. Awesome pieces. I don't think that's anything. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do that maybe, and then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do pink maybe, purple, sorry. And I don't know where it is, but I'm not even gonna care. And that's how you do it. I just needed to get this video out as soon as possible. If you enjoyed, make sure you click the subscribe button. If I think there was a lot of things that I missed, so yeah, that's it.